Hello again, everyone. Welcome back to Ogre Battle. All right, let's go with a new game again. But this time, we're going to put in a different name. Hi, Warren. Yep. But first, tell me your name, huh? Well, let's go with... Fireseal. Oops. Fireseal is a good name. Well, let's go with female. Alrighty, and I really don't remember which ones are which. It doesn't matter that much, so... After a long and difficult battle, your army has finally achieved victory. What do you credit your victory to? Those who fought with you. The night before a battle, you see several falling stars heading for the east. What do you wish for? Let's go with... Bravery for your army. You want to be sure that your knights abstain from disgraceful behavior. What do you warn them most about? Be kind to everyone. You are standing in front of a mirror which shows your best trait. What is shown in the mirror? Moral strength. Fate can be cruel. If you could only save one person from the flames of battle, who would it be? Your child. It is sometimes said that victory is only luck. What do you think luck is? Luck is something you create. Luck is unescapable. Bad luck can be good. Luck is something you create. And finally, please choose a tarot card from the deck. Give me something good. Ah, world card, not too bad. Oh gods, please grant to our leader bravery and honor, blah blah blah. Whatever. You've seen this all before. Okay, but instead of one of the other battles, or Warren's Island here, we have Dragon's Heaven. Let's take a look at the units that we have. Lexor is our lord. Level 15. Sword and Sonic Strike. So we got a, I think a neutral high, lord. Nice red hair there. Johann a paladin, Richard a paladin, Pockle a muse, Mangela a muse. Should probably just pull everyone out of this, these units. Hernandez a paladin, Donald a samurai, Chips... Hey, Chips is back! No, wait. Chips wasn't our... Was Chips our... No, it was Rick. Rick was our samurai. That's right. We got Shaker and Wise, and both ninjas. Muse. Ginger the Muse, Lloyd the paladin, Malkovich the paladin, and Apis the griffin. We start with a princess! Yeah! Pelline the princess, Shubalus the wyvern, Partis the lycanthrope, Franklin the lycanthrope, Kim the monk, Felia the seraphim, Vekka the seraphim, Arnold the paladin, Lord the paladin, Russell an eagleman, Brad the mage, Bernie the mage, and Agamemuno, the salamander, and Victor the Beastmaster, Pizos the Titan, Weinberg the Berserker, Elliot the Berserker, and we have some units here. We've got Maverick the Vampire, Iata, Enna, and Melina, all Nixies. We've got a Lich, Leonard. We've got Clive the Dragonmaster, Hector the Dragonmaster, and Doma the Dragonmaster. Well, first thing that we want to do is... Let's go ahead and remove most of these characters. First things that we have to do here are reset up these units, because they're not built very well. That one's actually okay. Let's go ahead and disband that one. Let's go ahead and disband that one. Let's go ahead and disband that one. And let's disband that one. Okay. So we need to add some new characters. Let's go ahead and let's see. Do we have anything else that's... go with Griffin, I suppose. And probably don't need an Eagle Man. I suppose I don't really need... Well, you know what? Shoot. Let's go ahead and sort our stock by class. Let's go ahead and rearrange our units, number order, change number. We'll set that to 3 for now. Oh, and I should probably remove these characters. Actually, you know what? I should probably put the, put the Wyvern in with our Lord's unit so that we can get a unit much like we had before. There's a Wyvern. Here it is. So there we go. And we get a Paladin. Are they all... They're not all level 15, but these two are were leaders, it looks like. What else do we want? Let's go with a Muse, I guess. I'll go with a Beastmaster. Yeah, let's go with the Beastmaster. That's fine. Let's change the formation a bit. That's fine. Alright, add characters. This will be a very powerful unit because we are going to add in the Lich. You're going to add in two Paladins. And a Seraphim. Alright, so we've got our super powerful unit there already. Let's go ahead. Let's see. What else do we want to build a unit out of? Well, we've got a dragon. I need a leader, so... So we've got some dragon masters. Let's have it be Clive's unit. So we could do ice field or swords. Let's see. I guess we can have a sword in the front. And we got Bite and Fire Breath on the Salamander. Let's go with Fire Breath. And we'll have another Dragon Master. There we go. So that is a Dragon unit. I guess we'll go with a Paladin unit. And we'll have two mages in the back. That's probably pretty good. There we go. And... we'll have Kim the Monk. We'll have a vampire here in the front. Two lycanthropes. And a Seraphim. Let's see. Let's go with... a Muse. Actually, I should probably, get some flying units in some of these. That's going to be plains type, unfortunately. Mountain type, plains, forest, snow, high sky. You really don't have that many other great units. I suppose I could have... Well, I'm not sure... Let's see what would happen if we put the Titan, the Griffin, and the Eagle Man all into one unit. And I don't think I'm going to use the Nixies. That's a high sky type. Alright, that's good. It's not bad. And then we've got... three Nixies. I don't know why I'm going to do that, but... That's fine. Maybe they can guard the base or something. Alright, can anyone... Well, we could turn the Griffin into a Cockatrice, but I'm not sure that I want to do that. I think Windstorm is going to be better. Yeah, let's leave that as is. I do need to modify the ranks of this party. Oops. There we go. Alright, I think that's good. Do we have any items? We have no items. Okay. That's okay. Let me go ahead and get onto the map. Alrighty. Alright, so we've got our... You know what? I completely forgot to set my timer. This will run a little bit long now that I've done all that. Alright, let's go to Dragon's Heaven. Now, I'll leave the Nixies in the base for now, since we can get a... This is not a very big map, by the way. Alright, we can recruit neutral dragons on this map, so I might try that. So, we've got... we start in Sukalamu. Dragon's Heaven is there, that's the fortress. We've got Mistafa here. We've got Bright Rock with a shop there. And we've got a... Roshian Temple there, and there is one hidden town right here. So, let's go ahead and deploy everyone. Except Melina. We'll leave Melina there. Let's actually have these guys... Go find that town, then we'll go check there for the treasure. And then I'm just going to get them off to the side. I'll figure out something to do with them a little bit later. First of all, let's go ahead and... there so that we can take the shop. I think I might use this as the defensive unit, the guardian unit, even though we've got the undead. Alright, so let's actually just basically have everyone move up to this everyone else move up to that that town there. Since our leader unit will get there first. actually move out a bit. Actually, let me pull up the list of things that we can actually meet here, neutral character-wise. So in the mountains, we can meet salamanders. We can meet zombie dragons in the shallows, and platinum dragons somewhere. So if I get any of those, I'll toss one into the Nixie unit. Alright, you guys can come up as well. And then I can deploy the Nixie unit. Otherwise, it's not that big of a deal. Although, I don't have a whole lot of money, so, found the city Mazwan. Liberated the trade city Brightrock. I will draw a card from the deck, and I pulled the tower card. Jeez. Character's alignment is 2 points down. I will keep the card, though. This is a heaven for dragons called Dragon's Heaven. We of this island are completely neutral, and we live here in peace with the dragons. However, that wizard Albellio has brought his foul army here and is disturbing our peace. So this is where that bastard went. Oh, I'm looking forward to killing him again. Please, use your power to protect the dragons. Well, let's see what is for sale. So we can get Joker Tarot's persuasion spells. Let's go ahead and get some Cure Onks. And some Ethereal Flutes. Suppose I could get some Joker Tarot's as well. Get some of those. I don't think I need a persuasion spell. Well, we'll see how it goes. Alright, we'll go up and liberate that. And I'll send my princess up there as well. Alright, so we're starting to get some enemies coming down. There are some Seraphim and a Salamander. And we've got a Devil, a Raven Man, a Devil, and a Raven Man. Holy crap! let's see, we've got a Witch, three Witches, and a Cockatrice. We've got a mage, a Tiamat, and a black dragon. A muse, and some wyverns. A samurai master, a sylph. Two more samurai masters. A dragon master, a gold dragon, and another gold dragon. Jeez. Alright, Russell has encountered the enemy. Let's see how he does in battle. I should have checked to see what he was set to. Probably want leader. Of course, it does firestorm, but it misses, luckily. Let's go ahead and turn off animation. And, of course, they do a meteor. So definitely not the best of units here, but... not sure how we'll do. Well, no, we won. That's good. We softened him up, but we took a lot of damage there. We liberated the Roshian Temple. Now we'll draw a card from the deck, pulled the Judgment card, hit points are up, that's very nice. I will keep that card. Found an item! Found a Flame Flail.
Welcome to our Roshian Temple. If anyone is killed, please bring them here. We will use the power of the gods to bring them back to us. May the gods smile upon you.
I do need to get someone else to come up. How about you? You're a good unit to come up here. Russell has encountered the enemy again. It's not quite what I want, but we're set to leader now, so maybe you can take out the... No, I don't think you can take out the leader. Not with that kind of damage. At least that missed. Come on, ow. Do I have... Oh, man. That's just judgment. Let's take them all out. Okay. Well, shucks. There goes getting all that treasure. All right, let's see. Actually, first of all, what does the flame flail do? Just strength plus 4. All right, let's... Oops, I want to equip flame flail. This would be a lot easier if I could use my normal party, but I cannot. Alright, Lexor's unit has encountered the enemy. That's okay. Hopefully they will be pretty good. Fingers crossed. Of course, there is an angel who can do jihad on us, and I was not set to leader. Okay. Let's see how this goes. We can do a lot of damage, at least. We've got a pretty good unit in that regard. So this is what my hero could have looked like. Well, I did win. That's the important thing. I should probably send up a couple more units. I gotta wait until he stops. Alright, a witch. I'm set to leader now, so hopefully we'll take out the witch. Let's see. Take out the witch. Take her out. I don't have anyone else who can get to the back row, unfortunately. That is a flaw in this party. Unfortunately, our Beastmaster is now stunned. And everyone else is stunned, except for the Wyvern. We still won. That's the important thing. Alright, Russell. Ow! No! Screw that! That is one of the reasons why I bought the ethereal flutes. Alright, let's go do that and get the item. Alright. My hero is continuing to encounter the enemy, unfortunately. Maybe I should have had her wait back at the base and taken these things with the princess. Since I do not have a priest in this unit, I cannot heal up other than by sitting at the temple itself. But the good news is that we've got some weakened units to face against. Fight. Hurry up and get up there, princess. I need you to defend my position here. There we go. No more stunning. And now we can concentrate on the cockatrice, and we should be able to take it out. Of course, if you miss Wyvern, that's less likely to happen. There we go. Might need to use an item to heal up my leader. We're going to be getting some more battles here. Oh, for want of 7-league boots. Well, at least this one is a depleted unit. Oh, wow, missed. Ow. Crap. Good. Not so good. Well, at least they're missing. I think I might have to use a Curonk after this. Oh, wow. They won. It's all because of the Jihad. Alright, let's go ahead and use a Curonk. Get some healing back there. Alright, there we go. I got there in time to not lose that city. Well, we took her out, at least. So that's one of the things that I don't like about this lord. I prefer the green Ice Cloud Lord rather than the Sonic Strike one here. Alright, encountered the enemy again. I should actually take a look at the stats of our units, see who would be best at liberating towns, because leader might not be. 97 damage, but he's still going to be around to cast some spells, unfortunately, and we are not doing much damage to these guys. We might lose this one, simply based on damage. Yeah. At least they only get that one spell. Ooh, well. Yep. Let's go ahead and use an ethereal flute. And I'm going to use some cure stones. That's good enough. There aren't a whole lot of enemies coming down there. Yeah, let's go ahead and take a look at our leader units and see who... Alright, so alignment and charisma, probably not the best unit to be... not the best unit for liberating towns. In fact, Pauline is probably the best. I should have thought about that before doing this. Alright, let's see. We've got Hernandez, who is pretty good, so let's actually have him go down here and liberate this town. And Pauline, we'll go up and liberate this one. Well, you guys are going to go up and camp in that place. Alright, well, they want to fight again, so... I can do that. I can fight you again. And now we will actually take out the leader before they can do any damage. There we go. Now, we are going to take a lot of damage from these dragons, but might be able to dish out a fair bit. Not sure how many attacks they're going to get. We've got the whip, though. That helps. The whip attack does a lot of damage. All right, we won. It's going to send that unit running back to base, but that's okay. Oh, I got a soul mirror. Just boost her alignment. I found buried treasure. A burning band. Wow, that is crappy. Alright, let's see. What do we have? We've got Kitty the Mermaid, Iaria the Kraken, and Crouton the Kraken. Let us... go that way. And head back to base. Ah, dang it. I was hoping they'd get around the mermaid. Ah, well, what are you gonna do? I should see about equipping that burning band. Now we are set to leader. That is not much damage. We are screwed. We can't take that. In fact, let's actually go there and heal up. And let's actually send our hero unit back to base. Now that we've got someone there, we'll get this fight taken care of, though. Most of our other groups probably will be able to hold out better. There is a Muse there who's going to do a lot of damage, so I suspect we're going to lose this one. Ow! 57! Jeez, maybe I should have put my Wyvern in the back row. And they get a second Thunder Flare, too. I forgot about that. Versus my single attack from my hero. Well, we're definitely losing this battle. Yep. That's okay. We'll have her run back to base. If we were Ellie, it'd be just fine. But no, they couldn't give us Ellie. Supposedly there's a way into the stage by unlocking an item, and you can get the item. You need to have... oh wow, I've never seen the salamander from the back before. Euros, Notos, Bolius, and Zephyros? I think that's what they call it in this game. But it's kind of... you know what? You are not set to leader. Dang it. This next Thunder Flare is going to hurt. We might actually lose... Oh, well, we lost the leader. That's going to be pretty much an automatic loss. Yeah. Well, now that they're set to leader, it should be a little bit better in the future. Oh, yeah, Burning Band. Ethereal Flute. On you. And a Cure Stone. On you. All right, might lose this, this temple, I'm not sure. Nope. Roshian Temple was taken over by the Empire. Boo indeed. That hurts my reputation. Johan's unit has encountered the enemy. Well, let's quickly switch back to... quickly switch to leader. This unit will be able to murder them. Because we'll do decent damage against the wyverns. And we've got two mages. Nice. Very nice. We liberated the Roshian Temple. Fantastic. And we'll draw a card from the deck, pull the Sun card. Maybe that just set the time back, that's fine. Oh, we'll keep the card though. Ah! Our princess is meeting some samurai. This should be great. Ah, Starlight. Oh, that Starlight does not do much damage, though. Oh, I missed that damage. Ow! That... You know, what do you... You're... You want to be set to leader. Alright, this unit could probably use a priest, couldn't it? Well... Took out a lot of units, so... That's okay. Alright, so we're gonna have a witch here. And at least we'll do more damage against the witches. I think. I hope. Come on, do more damage! Well, that's crappy. I got a 41 out of it. And we got an acid cloud. There we go, and they all die. That's the important thing. The important thing is that they all die. What do we have here? So, a mage, Tiamat, and the black dragon. Okay. Here we've got... Hand the palette. Oh. Well, first of all, let's see. That is fire plus 6, ice plus 4. I don't know, whatever. Give it to him. Nope, not going to purchase anything else. Let's go ahead and steal that princess. She only has 97 hit points, but she is a princess. Oh my, you can't persuade a princess? Oh, that was just a ripoff. It's not automatic? Oh, that's total ripoff. Damn it. I thought it would be automatic. Well, crap. That was just a waste of 50,000... 50,000 Goth? I don't care about a stupid paladin. Eh, grumble, grumble. Well, at least we took care of that, mage before he could do anything, but now maybe I should move my people apart a little bit. The two knights, I mean. I got some levels. There we go. And I found a dowsing rod. Alright, Hernandez has encountered the enemy. Let's see, how are you? You are not quite healed up, but it's probably good enough. Let's see about the item up there. Then we'll send him back. Alright, Hernandez, how are you going to do against this unit? Alright, you did go after the right one. Let's make sure you're set to leader, though. Good. Ow. We do not do much damage to the dragons. Very disappointing. So this is a more normal battle. This is not my, you know, massively overpowered unit types. Excuse me. Even by this point when I had level 15 characters, my guys were significantly more powerful than this, though. So it's a big difference. Alright, Johan has encountered the enemy. I'll end this one shortly, and then we'll, Alright, what do we set to? We set to leader, good. And the leader only has 92 hit points, so that'll be a help. Oh, that's just a standard mermaid, not a Nixie. Oh, good. And we missed her twice. Damn it. Well, there goes all of our magic, but at least we'll get a sword we can slash at her with. Half tempted to move our knight leader into the back row for healing purposes. Liberated the fortress city, Mustafa. Come on, give me a temperance or like a good fortune card. Oh god. Well, my reputation is crapping out. I will keep that card though.
I thought that Abilio had died in Balmoa. Well, he was a student of Rashidi. It seems that he foresaw his own death and made preparations to be revived. They are here to find powerful dragons to add to their army for the Empire. Please use your power to protect the dragons.
Alright, well, we'll go ahead and call this an episode, and in the next one, we'll find the item that's there, and then head up here and take the enemy castle, I guess. Well, we need to free this town, too. So we'll do both those in the next all three of those things in the next episode, and then that will be it with Ogre Battle. So this is basically the penultimate episode, I think. See you then, everyone!